sections in clinical examination. Our session today is about cardiovascular examination. We are going to start with the examination of the heart. Before you are doing the examination, you have to introduce yourself. Assalamu alaikum. And you have to have the agreement of the patient before commencing the examination of the heart. Examination of the heart, I prefer to start from the peripheral finding of heart diseases. Then you go and concentrate on the cardiac area. Starting by the general condition of the patient. Is the patient in distress, shortness of breath, which means the patient probably in heart failure? Is the patient cyanosed? Is the patient conscious or unconscious? These are all things which is might remark for evidence of heart problems. I start by examination of the hand of the patient, starting by the nail. First, you inspect to see if there is any nicotine staining, which suggests on a heavy smoker, which might be related to the ischemic heart disease, which is a risk factor for atherosclerosis. And then you look for the clubbing. Is there any clubbing? And if there is any suspicion of clubbing, you do this, right? Or you can. So we check the vein. Looking for the diamond slit. If it's lost, mean there is an clubbing of the fingers. Well, relation of the clubbing to the cardiovascular disease, in which a problem might be related to infective endocarditis, congenital cyanotic heart disease, infective endocarditis, atherosclerosis. These are things in the heart disease related to clubbing. And then you look for the if there is any splinter hemorrhage, which indicate what? Infective endocarditis. Again, the color of the nail is very important. Cyanosis, meaning there is a peripheral cyanosis, which might be related to central cyanosis in the congenital cyanotic heart disease. Advanced heart failure, severe mitral stenosis, all these might be later on causing the cyanosis. And you also look for the color of the nail in addition to cyanosis. If there is any pallor of the nail, this means suggest an anemia, which might be related to infective endocarditis. And don't leave the nail without assessment of the peripheral circulation by pressing on the nail for five seconds, and then you release for 15 seconds, and then you release the pressure. And the circulation should return immediately or within 5 seconds if the peripheral vascular circulation is normal. And then you go for the anemia, valve anemia, which is related to the, it might be the cause of heart failure or it might be a result of infective endocarditis, right? And you should examine both hands at the same time for the same things which I mentioned now. And then after that, you go to the examination of the radial pulse for the rate, rhythm, and the state of the vessel wall. And you should count the pulse for at least 15 seconds and multiplying by 4 if it is regular. But if it is irregular, you need to do the counting for about 12 minutes. The place you put the palm of your fingers is just medial to the styloid process and by the palm of your 3 fingers. And you start to count. It's preferable to do it at the same time, simultaneously, for the following reason. So if there is an absent, one side absent radial pulse, this is normally 5%, or if there is any intervention at that side, the absent side, and at the same time you spare the time of examinations in the examination, and you need to compare the the pulse intensity in both sides, which might be reduced in qualification of either one side. And then you examine for the collapsing pulse in this way, either by putting this side or putting this side. You can put this side or you can use this side. These are the most sensitive areas, and after right, and you lift it gently perpendicular. If there is any collapsing pulse, there will be hammering over this part of your hand, and this is called water hammer or collapsing pulse, which might occur either due to disease problem or due to the unusual physiological problem. Disease problem, the most important is the aortic incompetence, IV connections anywhere within the heart or outside the heart, and if there is any increase in the hemodynamic states due to the fever, exercise, anemias, pregnancies, all this might be related to a normal physiologically collapsing pulse. So you lift the hand in this way and you wait for about half minute to assess this character of the pulse. This is the technique, and later on I'm going to talk about the type of pulse. And you go to the eyes, and in the eyes, you look for anemia or jaundice. Anemia, the same significance. And jaundice, what is the relation of jaundice to heart? Jaundice might be related to the congestive hepatic congestion, or it might be related to the infectious endocarditis. So you need to examine for anemia. And even for cyanosis, it will be congested eyes, suffused eyes. And go to the oral cavity, feel it sonic for, looking for the central cyanosis, and look for the hygiene of the mouth, which is might be relevant to the infective endocarditis. This is again, you need to check it in any patient with fever. And to the neck, you examine for the vessels, which are the two important vessels, the jugular venous pressure. You assess the jugular venous pressure by putting the patient in 45 degree, and you look to the uppermost. You look for the two the uppermost pulsation in the neck, and you measure it above the sternal angle. By definition, the jugular venous pressure is the vertical height above Lewis angle. For example, if you find a pulsation in this area, you just point to this area and you make this is a horizontal parallel to the floor or to the bed, and you put this is the ruler, you put it in this way perpendicular on Lewis angle, and the crossing point is this, and you read it, which is a 3 centimeter. This is normal. Anything a 3, 4 and below, or 3 and below, consider a normal jugular venous pressures. You know the normal height is up to from 0 to 3 from the right atrium, but from Lewis angle to the uppermost pulsation should not exceed 3 point something. In a normal person. And the jugular venous, but it's just the jugular venous veins having 3 courses. The lower third is between the 2 heads of the sternomastoid, and the middle third is just under the sternomastoid, and the upper third is the behind the mandible in the front of the and in front of the sternomastoid. And if you couldn't evaluate, couldn't see the uppermost pulsation, you need to do gentle pressure, and you tilt the patient head like that, and you just do gentle pressure on the abdomen after asking the patient if there's any pain or not. You just press and not. And you have to have good light. You have to have good light, and you should look in this way tangentially, and you assess the level of the jugular venous pulsation. And you should examine on both sides in the same way. And you need to decide what type of jugular venous pulsation, which we are going to talk about later, whether it is pulsatile, non-pulsatile, whether it is coming during the respiration down or going up during the respiration, because each statement means a disease problem. Right. And after assessment of the jugular venous pressure, you need to assess the carotid, which is the significance of the carotid and the brachial nerve. The same, these are the large vessels. And you need to assess in this way. Just press gently over the carotid artery, each one at each time. Don't do it on both sides at the same time. And you, from this, you can assess the circulation time, you can assess the character of the pulse, and you can assess the pulse measures. And on the left side, you do it this way. And by this, you can judge whether there is any. And sometimes you can even feel a bruit in the narrow carotid arteries. These are the neck examination regarding the heart, and then we go to the brachial area. After measuring the pressure, you have blood pressure, please. I prefer to keep it at the end of the examination, keep it at the end. This is the rubber band, should be put in this way, over a neck skin, above the cubital fossa, and the brachial artery should be in the middle of the bladder of the sphygmoid. We will wait for the brachial artery, and the hand, the arm, sorry, should be at the same level of the heart. But this doesn't matter whether above or down. This should be, and you go until the brachial pulse disappear. And once it disappear, you go one 30 millimeter or more. And you bring it down slowly, 2 millimeter to 3 millimeter per second. And once the sound appear, this has been the diastolic. And once it's severe, this means the diastolic. And you should measure the blood pressure at both sides. At both sides. In the same way. Usually they are equal, symmetrical, but sometimes there is a difference, should not exceed 5 to 10 millimeter mercury, but usually they are the same reading. And again at the same level, which we are going to discuss it in the examination of hypertensive patients. The same principle you follow. And once there is a difference, you have to suspect for rectation of aorta. And in this case, you need to look for radiofemoral delay. Should be direct over the femoral artery, which is situated midway between the pubic symphysis and the iliacris, just below the inguinal ligament. And there should be no delay, and there should be the same intensity in normal person. But when there is any difference, there will be a radiofemoral delay, right? Now we are going to the brachial area, and in the brachial area you have to know that there is the landmark. You have to know this is the in the right second pulse space, there's the aortic area, left second pulse of the pulmonary area, and in the third fourth is the tricuspid area, and in the fifth intercostal within the midclavicular line, the mitral area. And you need to do a proper inspection for what? For any evidence of any pulsations, unusual pulsation or abnormal pace pulsation, and if there is any bulge of the precordium suggesting a long-standing cardiomegaly, particularly if it started in the childhood, there might be an bulging of the chest, and you have to look for a scar with sternotomy or a scar in the other part of the precordial area or the cardiac surgery, which might suggest a cardiac lesion. And these are by inspection. And then you go to palpate for any, you first palpate for the apex beat, starting from the very peripheral and then coming down, coming to the its normal position. And palpate for any other pulsation, pulmonary pulsation, aortic pulsation. And then you need to palpate for the heave, right ventricular heave. أخد نفس طلعة إجاب. This is for the right parasternal heave. If there is any heaving, you will have a lifting of your hand. And you need to feel for a thrill, for palpable sound, first heart sound, which suggests an atabic apex beat, which is seen characteristically in mitral stenosis. After doing the palpation, you go to auscultate the heart. And the auscultation, you start to auscultate the mitral area by the bell for mitral stenosis, rumbling diastolic murmur. But beforehand, I need you to secrete all the area, and you have to have idea about the heart sound or any other sound. Normally, you have the first, second heart sound. You might have other added sound. You start by mitral area, tricuspid area, and you ascend on the left sternal border to the pulmonary area, to the aortic area. For the mitral valve lesion, which is could be incompetent mitral valve lesion, mitral regurgitation, the mitral usually bounces systolic murmur in between the first and second heart sound, which is half its maximum intensity, the mitral area radiating, propagating to the left axilla. And for the mitral stenosis, you will have a rumbling diastolic murmur, which is a localized murmur, usually in the mitral area, which is not radiated. And sometimes you need to tilt the patient slightly in order to make it very near. And for auscultation of murmur regarding the tricuspid area, usually the murmur in the tricuspid area, and probably it is going down to over the hepatic area, particularly in tricuspid regurgitation, you all have an pulsatory liver, hepatic pulsation. And all the murmur from the aortic valve and the pulmonary mitral coming down through along the left cerebral border. So when you hear a murmur here, you probably your murmur is coming from above. But the most prominent murmur which we usually hear here in this area is the VSD murmur, which is advanced systolic murmur, harsh in quality. The pulmonary murmur due to stenosis is an ejection systolic murmur, which is radiated above to the left side of the neck root and even in the infraclavicular area. But it is maximum intensity in the pulmonary area. And for for the murmur of the pulmonary regurgitation, the murmur will come down, which called Graham C murmur, the same quality of the aortic regurgitation. How about you get down? Put it in a fence. This is for the murmur of the pulmonary regurgitation. And for the aortic stenosis, the murmur usually the an ejection murmur, and it is usually radiating to all bricolor area, particularly to the left parasternal area. And characteristically, it's going to the neck, which is called aortic shutter. If anything, you hear for the aortic murmur radiation, which is the ejection systolic murmur. For the aortic regurgitation, auscultate our aortic area and go over the left parasternal area, and you have to set the patient in the same way. Khudh nafas tan'a ega, and you will have the early diastolic blowing murmur of aortic regurgitation. You may have another added sounds, which is seen in the mitral prolapse systolic click, which is might be mid or late, and probably you might have an in the case of the aortic stenosis, pulmonary stenosis, you will have an ejection systolic click. Right. These are the examination of the auscultation of the heart. You need to auscultate for the basis over the basis of the lung. Nervous. Particularly if you have JVP elevated. And when there is JVP elevated, you have to palpate for the liver. Nervous. And if you suspect infective endocarditis, you have to palpate for severe. Akhudun nafas any. And don't forget to examine for the neck edema on both sides. Rest for half minute. No beating. So this is the cardiovascular examination. There is no need to do an percussion in the cardiovascular examination. It is limited, its value is limited, very limited, only if there is an unusual cardiac effusion and you need to assess the separation between the dullness and the pulsating aortic beat. And this is the probably give on a clue for the amount of the pericardial effusion, which is very weak. Right. Do you have any questions? Now, in the examination, if you ask to do a cardiovascular examination, you need to do the following thing. This is the way of doing the examination. Thank you. شكرا جزيلا. This is the quick examination in the, if you are asking to do it in a short case examination. Now, shall we go to discuss the significance of each steps? Regarding the nail, it's very important to assess the peripheral circulation by pressing for a while, and half a minute, and then you remove it. This should, the color should come very quickly. Within 5 seconds should be clear normally. And then you examine the nail for the clubbing, as we said, and we have to have the significance of clubbing in the regarding the heart. And you, as you know, clubbing related to the congenital cerebral heart disease, related to the infective endocarditis, atrial myxoma. And you have to examine the pulse properly, and the pulse need to be examined for what? For the rate, which is normally fetal rate, 60 to 100, rhythm, whether regular or not, should be regular. Well, regular, it might be normal regular, or it might be sugar aim. It might be abnormal regular. Abnormal, should say abnormal regular. Yeah, regular. Where there is an bigeminy or there is a nodal rhythm, this is usually a regular irregularity or regular arrhythmia. And you need to assess the character of the pulse. What are the character of the pulse? هو usually normal إلى ما بي character معينة, but the other abnormal character هي هي شنو هي؟
large volume pulse
اللي هي large volume might be normal might abnormal. شوكت normal large volume pulse, شوكت abnormal. large volume in hyperdynamic circulation, fever, pregnancy, if there is an CO2 retention, كلها سير bounding pulse or large volume pulse. And abnormal and there is an aortic regurgitation, whether it's on arteriovenous communication anywhere in the body. But the difference, شنو difference بين هذول الاثنين؟ شنو difference, مصطفى؟ difference هذا البلس البرجر يكون very wide بالنسبة للأورت يكون فيستولة, وذاك البلس البرجر يكون narrow بالنسبة للنورمال large volume. Right. فإذا this is the collapsing pulse. What other pulse? Actually collapsing شنو هو؟ anaplotic pulse or low volume pulse اللي يصير بالaortic stenosis. We know what sometimes we have both the يبدي no high بعدين انقطع نسميه شو نسميه بسفيريانس pulse. هذا يصير بcombined aortic lesion, combined aortic lesions. The other pulse abnormality, paradox pulse. Paradox pulse اللي هو البلس نورمال ايش يصير بيه؟ من يسوي الاسبريشن ينزل مو شكل, بينما هذا يزيد. Paradox pulse هذا شنو كاركترستيك اوف الديزيز؟ Paradox
pulse بريكارديا تومبنا,
بريكارديا تومبنا
سيفير اسمه.
This is a characteristic of the بعد other type of abnormal pulse تعرفوه؟
Pulsus alternans.
Pulsus alternans هذا بالهارت فيلر اللي هي عكس الكاتريكا alternans, يعني هذاك اي سي جي فايندينغ, هذا كلينيكال فايندينغ اللي هي بلس قوية وبلس ضعيفة يصير بالهارت فيلر. شنو سبب البلس الضعيفة؟ الهارت ضعيف بامبينج, بعدين من يرتاح يلا يضرب الضربة الأخرى تجي قوية. واحدة ضعيفة هاي هي صفاتها, واحدة هي collection of its power and then pushing the blood in this way نسميه pulses alternans. ولا
pulses experience
حكينا عليه بعد. Pulse deficit. Pulse deficit هي difference between the precordial counting and the radial counting. اللي هي إيش قد نعتبرها مزيانة حيل, يعني abnormal pathological. إذا تعدت 5 per minute فهاي لا نعتبرها بشيء يعني significant. And we have to look after it, yeah. Looking for cause and usually هذا يصير بالأتريال فيبريشن. هي البلس deficit تصير بالإكتوبكس وتصير بالأتريال فيبريشن. بعد أداء البلس راديو فيمرال دري, طبعا هذا اللي يدون النباتية هذا. فانت ما تعد البلس الا بالك هاي كل الافكار, تروح للجي في بي تفحصه مثل ما قلنا النورمال ليفل, وهسه قبل شوي حكينا النورمال ليفل, بس الى جي في بي از هاي يا اما بلستايل, خلينا نقول بلستايل
سوبرير بين كاب
او ستاكشن هذا سوبرير بين كاب ولا بلستي فيا اما هذا ينزل ويا الانسبريشن وهي هاي نورمال واما يروح عكس هاي شنو نسمي هذا؟ كوزموس سايز اللي هي كاركترستيك اوف فيكتيزيز كاليكتون بنادو اجين كوزموس هذا جي بي بي كاروتيد اكزامينيشن فيري امبورتنت يو هاف تو فيل ات يو هاف تو اسكالتيت اوبن الفيلينج احنا ندور بروي بصراحه وهذا كلش مهم ذول اللي يجونا تي اي اي يجونا ستروك سم تايم يعني خطيه عندهم السورس مالتهم فيو هاف تو اسكالتيت اوفر ان اني كارد اكزامينيشن اف يو دونت اسكالتيت اوفر ذا كاروتيد ارتري ما يعتبرك الاكزامينر انت بيرفكت يعني كونسلتنت So you have to auscultate over the both carotids and at each time and you have to ask the patient to stop breathing. Stop breathing, hold the breathing. تسمع البروي إن سمعته this suggests أنا more than 70% occlusion. يعني عادة 50 to 70% occlusion which is might be significant and might need interference either by stenting or by a surgery. Right? It's very important I need. Well, it might be the clue of the strokes, and you go down to the heart and the mental magnetic inspection. كلش مهم هذا. Well, بس إذا بقولكم من الروح على inspection pulsation cardiac abdomen. شنو هو تعريف cardiac abdomen؟ شنو تعريفه بالضبط؟ It is the outermost, lowermost, visible or and palpable cardiac pulsation, which have and this is in the 15th intercostal space within the mediclavicular line 9 cm from the mid line 1 cm for the mediclavicular line and should have no character ثلاث خطوط حمر جوال بس السيرفير او بس يقتل هذا التعريف يعني it is the outermost lowermost visible or unbulbable بس يقتل have no character يعني بس يسميها character هذا abnormal What are the abnormal character of the abductivity that we have to show?
Diffuse,
forcible, ill-sustained, thrusting, high, this is abnormal. Diffuse, thrusting, يعني قصدي forcible, sustained, this suggests an heave, ventricular heave. And this is an suggests an LVH. This is again important. If it is stabbing like that, this is suggests a mitral stenosis. So, يعني each type of the cardiac pulsation might give an a clue to the disease problem, character. I mean, each character of the abductivity might be a clue for other noises. The other abnormal pulsation اللي نحسه هنا, sometimes parasternal third heart sound, sometimes palpable, but it is difficult to say it. The prominent pulsation اللي sometimes it even in normal هو second left intercostal space in pulmonary, خصوصاً بليان people, but sometimes it is suggesting, خصوصاً لا forcible, just to suggest on a pulmonary hypertension. You should be careful about that. Pulmonary hypertension, the clue مات عادة prominent pulsation بال pulmonary area, وهيف من left برسينال suggest on a right ventricular heave. وهذا very important, وهذا misdiagnosis, يجوكم. Shortness of breath, chest pain, A lot of things تسوي له إيكو أسريع ما تحصل كل شيء إذا ما تخلي بباله and you have to measure the pressure pulmonary pressure across the mitral sorry tricuspid valve and this is again these are important point in the examinations these are the and you have to be careful about the thrills because once you find the thrills معناها رفع الدقري مع المرمر مالتك above 3 يعني بدون منافس وبدون نقاش. So you have to feel for the thrill. What is the meaning of thrill? Thrill is a palpable murmur and it is due to the turbulence of the blood across an vessel. شنو معنى المرمر؟ A turbulence flow. Either due to increased velocity or decreased diameter of the passage of the blood. Right. These are important points اللي تخليها بالك من تفحص المريض. الأذر ثينجز اللي نريد نحكي عليها هي التايب اوف مرمرز تعرفوا انتم الهارت ساوندز هي دبل ساوندز اس 1 اس 2 ممكن نضرب لها عدد ساوند نورمالي ثلاث هارت ساوند موجود الى 40 بعضهم يقول لك اكثر ويعني عاده يكون اب نورمال ابوف ذيس الفورث هارت ساوند يوجوالي اب نورمال وتعرفون كل ساوند هو شنو السبب مالته. الفيرست هارت ساوند هو كلوجر او ذا ميتال بار تاع الكسبت، والسكند هارت ساوند هو شنو هو؟ فال ذا ايورتيك فال اند بولمونري فال، والثير هارت ساوند هو فلوج اوف هذا، والفورث هو كونتراكشن اوف ذا اتريك كونتراكشن. الكليكات هي سببها للسينوسيس وسببها للانكريز بريجر. اي بريجر يجي يعني على مود تفتح اجينست ذس بريجر يسوي كليك، واي ستينوسيس من دي ينفتح يسوي كليك. فهاي الكليكس ممكن سيستوليك كليكيوج فاليو. و اي ونت يو جست تو يعني تو بي كيرفول تو اسس ذا مرمر. اولا المرمر شود بي تايم سيستوليك اور دايستوليك، شود بي لوكالايز، شود بي شود انتنس، شود بي ديسايدد. مالتو انتنسيتي راديشن مالته كلش مهم، الفاريشن وذ ريسبريشن كلش مهم، and variation with posture again هو هذا مهم كلها. there are certain diseases اللي تقدر تشخصها في هاي الشغلات اللي مهمة. ف يعني you need to pay attention for this finding بالمرمر. المرمر systolic diastolic هو كلش مهم. المرمر sometimes not pathologic، not every murmur is a pathologic. sometimes the murmur is due to the increased flow. مثل ما قلنا هو flow turbulence. فمن يزيد الفلو يعني in certain condition ممكن يسوي مرمر هو مو ديزيز، خصوصا بالانيميك بيشنت، بالبريجنسي، بالفيري يانج اكتيف كذا. هاي يسميه انوسيت مرمر. هاي صفات المرمر، شوفه مره موجود مره ما موجود. الانتنسيتي مالته يوجوال ذات هاي وفاريبل فاريبل وذ ايفريثينج وذ ريسبريشن وذ بوستنج يعني. فسو اتس نوت ان فيكست مرمر اللي هو مثل ما نشوف في الباثولوجيكال مرمر. كل المطلوب منك في الامتحان هو انت تعرف التايب اوف مرمرز وتعرف الديزيز بروبلم اللي تسويها. يعني انت راح تخلي ديفرنشال دايجنوز سم تايم، سم تايم يو كان نوت ريتش ا ريال دايجنوزز، سو يو نيد تو بوت ا ليست. يعني مثلا فور اكزامبل اف يو فايند ان مرمر وان ستريت مرمر ان ذا ريال بروتين اريا، انت نوبات تحير هل هو هذا ذيس از ا بي اس دي، يعني لو هو بارت اوف ذا ميترال ريجيتيشن، او لو بات سم تايم مرمر يكون كونتينيوس مرمر. يعني خصوصا بالبيت اندكتس ارتيريوسس او بالالومنيوم هاب دبل ليجن دبل بارب ليجن ايرتيك ليجن الانكومتنس سيسوي المرمر سور سيستوليك ودايستوليك متواصل. فسام تايم اتس ديفيكالت تو سيبريت سيستوليك فروم دايستوليك، سو بليز بي كيرفول. سو يو نيد تو بوت ا ديفرنشال دايجنوز، نوت اول ذا تايم يو كانت سي فور شور ذا دايجنوز. اند ات ذا اند اوف اكزامينيشن تو بي اون ذا سيف سايد قول الفايندينج مالتك. Well, I need to do an echocardiogram for this patient to decide or to know the type of the lesion exactly. هذا موضوعنا اليوم، إن شاء الله انتهى.
Thank you.